You're always talking about leaving. Milk carton, black and white face.
It's actually really hot in Taipei right now. I think it was worse in the summer, so I'm happy that I got here near September, like, you know, the end of August. But still, it's still like 35 degrees every day and it's so humid that I am sweating all the time. Like, as soon as I step out of my house, I'm just sweating. I've had to have a few showers a day to deal with the heat, and I'm still kind of regretting going just walking at this time. It's 10:30, so it's not even that crazy yet, but still you can really feel it and it's not nice.
Paris waiting in the driveway.
Guys, actually a success, because I went into that like little market thing that there was going on at that park, and there was the Swedish guy who gave me this handmade soap, aloe vera I think it is, from his small handmade soap company based in Tainan, and it was so nice, so very happy.
Why you packing up your suitcase? Hasn't anybody told you?
And it's honestly so cute. I really enjoy it here. It's so calm, peaceful, and just really nice to chill. So perfect plan for a Saturday morning, really. And I met this guy who was playing some kind of traditional instrument. I don't really know what it was, and he was so lovely. We're going now to flower market. I think it's called Jianghuo Flower Market. I'm quite excited. But it was very nice because I was sitting next to this old man singing some traditional Chinese music. Actually, I can cross, so follow me. And this lady came up to me and she was like, oh, I hope this doesn't disturb you and it's not too noisy for you. And I was like, no, not at all, it's very nice actually. And she's like, oh, I'm really glad you like it. And I was like, yeah. So we're now crossing. This is really funny because there's those four-way crossings all around the city. And it feels like, I don't know, I'm in the middle of the road, it's kind of spooky, but yeah. I was gonna go to an exhibition, and then I got a call from my friend saying that we're going to a hot spring spa thingy, like public one, and I thought that was a good idea. What I didn't think of is that it was actually now when I had to go, so I'm basically running gonna grab my bikini and also need to have some lunch, I guess, on the way. But yeah, look at these beautiful views I have of the National Theatre? Opera? Not sure. Just having a very chill Sunday morning. I basically just tidied up my room because it was really messy, and now I'm gonna start doing some scrapbooking. I think I got this scrapbook thingy from my friends last year, and I wanna now start doing a new scrapbook series about my Taiwan experience. So I also bought yesterday this postcard. Basically, wherever I go, I use bike postcards, as you can see there and there. But I have a lot of leaflets and stuff, so I think I can do something cute with it. We're gonna experiment. I haven't done scrapbooking in so long, but I really wanted to do it this time for my whole Taiwan experience. So I'll take you guys along. As you can see, I already have a lot of leaflets and different things. Also, I got this stamp yesterday, and as if you didn't know, in Taiwan, everywhere you go, there's stamps, and you can stamp your own, you know, notebooks for free. And they have so many different stamps, but the problem is, I never have paper in hand to actually use the stamps. But this time, I got this one when I bought my postcard, and I think it's really cute, so I'm gonna probably cut it off, and I'll make sure to bring some more paper with me every time I go somewhere in Taiwan. But yeah, I have a lot of cute things I'm gonna use, stickers. We'll see. So today, next thing we're doing is studies on Chinese, and for today I'm gonna be reviewing one class I had last Tuesday, I believe it was, about Chinese stories. It was my first class, and the class was very good. It was good listening practice, it was 100% Chinese, but there was this problem that she was just speaking and going really fast, so I didn't really have time to actually understand a lot of what was being said. So what I'm gonna do is go through the text and highlight all the words I don't know, and yeah. Which I know I should have watched a long time ago, but I actually never watched it. Sorry about the background noise. So we'll see. The film's gonna be obviously be in English with Chinese subtitles, because if not, that would have been so hard. I miss your song. Want you around.